Military training routes allow pilots flying military jets to become proficient in tactical low-level flying. The routes provide a way for the aircraft to operate faster than the normal 250-knot limit below 10,000 feet MSL. There are a number of them shown on the chart, as you can see here. You'll notice the routes can begin with VR, which represents VFR routes, meaning routes not under ATC control, and these are usually 1,500 feet AGL or less, but there are exceptions. The IR or IFR routes are under ATC control and are above 1,500 feet AGL. Notice the IR routes have three-digit numbers after them. The three-digit numbers means there is at least one segment of the route above 1,500 feet AGL. You would expect that for the IR routes. Most of the VR routes have four-digit numbers, meaning the segments are at 1,500 feet AGL or below. But notice some VR routes have three digits, so at least one segment of the VR route is above 1,500 feet. The arrows dictate which way the routes are flown. The width of the route can be from 4 miles either side of a line up to 16 miles. My understanding is one route may go as wide as 25 miles on one side. Although you are not prohibited, it is best to avoid MTRs if possible. But if you are not able to, you will want to cross them at 90 degree angles to get through them as quickly as possible, and you will want to keep your eyes open for any possible traffic. Flying parallel to a MTR is not a good idea for obvious reasons. Also, you will want to contact a flight service station to determine if a MTR is in use. We talked about a couple of ways to contact flight service stations in the Military Operations Areas video. There is another way by looking at VOR information on the sectional chart. In this example, I will be flying north above Santa Rosa, and I notice there's a VOR station near the airport. I see the frequency 122.1, which means I can talk to the Albuquerque FSS on 122.1. The R means the FSS can only receive on that frequency, so I can transmit on COM1 with that frequency. The 117.8, normally used for VOR navigation, is now used to listen as the number is not underlined. If the frequency was underlined, we could not use it to listen to FSS. So we will dial to 117.8 on NAV1 to listen to FSS as we communicate with them. We will be crossing where it says VR1195, which shows traffic would come from the west, but we would also want to consider VR1107, which has traffic coming from the east. In reality, since both routes are 1,500 feet AGL or below, we could just fly above those routes. But if we had to fly through them, we could contact Albuquerque, as we discussed, and say something like the following. Albuquerque Radio, Cessna November 20905 Kilo, 5 miles south of Santa Rosa at 6,000 feet. What is the status of military routes Victor Romeo 11905 and Victor Romeo 1107? Then we could react based on the information we receive from FSS. Subscribe to this channel to learn more.